So this video is gonna be a really quick video for who are interested in creating gun effect without spending too much time on it. So recently, I had to edit the gunfight scenes because we made John Wick inspired comedy film. Today, I wanna share my solution that I applied for our project. So let's go through only the essential steps and tools you need to know to create gun effects. So mainly, we will be using After Effects plugin called Bang from Red Giant.
You might be familiar with the Bang plugin already, but it might be confusing at first because this program is part of Red Giant package, which itself is part of Max One's product. To use Bang, you just need to try Red Giant, which contains various effect plugins. For the Max One package, which includes everything they offer, you don't have to get that, so be careful. You can start with a free trial that lasts 2 weeks. For the most short film project, this should be enough time to complete your work. Once you download the software, you get a package manager, Maxon app, where you can install a specific program. Go to Red Giant product and choose VFX suits. After installations, you can start working in After Effects. Let's start by opening After Effects and importing your video footage. Place the clip you want to add the gun effect to in your composition. I'll demonstrate using a shot from a John Wick-inspired comedy film where we added gun effect using the Bang plugin. Go to your effect panel and search for Bang. Drag the effect onto your footage. In the effect control panel, you see the various customization options. The basic concept is to position the gun overlay where your actor is holding the weapon, then customize the muzzle flash appearance and environment around it. First, select your gun type from the overlay option. Choosing the right type of the gun type helps you to position your effect more easily. We use pistol, for example.
Now let's try to move our guns to the specific positions.
I recommend using the 3D option as it's more intuitive. You can adjust the position horizontally, vertically, and in depth. Think of it working in a 3D space. Moving the closer to the camera makes the gun and muzzle flash appear larger. Once you position the gun, you need to match its rotation to how the actor is holding it. You can adjust this using sweep fields and roll control. This allows you to spin the gun around in any direction to match the actor's grip. You might need to tilt it slightly, adjust the roll, or make small adjustments to get it perfectly aligned with the actor's hand. You can also adjust the scale if needed. Next, add the keyframe to define when the gun fires. For pistol, you might want a single frame of muzzle flash, while for automatic weapons, you need multiple keyframes. You can customize the muzzle flash shape, add the petals around it, include sparkles, and adjust colors. Another important feature is interactive lighting. This allows muzzle flash to affect the environment light around it. You can adjust intensity of this effect through this interactive setting, though keep in mind that After Effects may need some time to render these changes. Remember to add supporting effects like smoke for more realism. In our short film, we included smoke effect to enhance authenticity. These small details make a significant difference in selling the effect.
So I'll keep you posted for more content like this to edit and shoot entertaining film. If you want more tutorials like this, please like and subscribe. I'm your hero. See you in the next one.